Hi little skeletons, it is Disney Queen Skelly here, and welcome back to another Disney Media Review. Today we are reviewing The Big Bad Wolf, so let's get into it. IMDb rating 7.1 out of 10 stars, runtime 9 minutes. Plot summary 1. Red Riding Hood is accompanied by Fiddler Pig and Piper Pig as she takes a shortcut through the forest to deliver food to her sick grandmother. Plot summary 2. The two foolish pigs escort Red Riding Hood on a short cut through the woods, against the advice of their bricklaying brother. When they encounter the wolf, Red runs ahead to Granny's house and the pigs run home. The wolf gets to Grandma's house first and scares her into the closet, then dresses as Granny. Alerted by his brothers, the smart pig arrives just as Granny is pulled Red into the closet with her and takes care of the wolf with the help of some hot coals and popcorn. Plot summary 3. Not listening to the advice of Practical Pig, Red Riding Hood, Fiddler Pig, and Piper Pig take a shortcut through the forest to Grandmother's house. Along the way, they run into the Big Bad Wolf disguised as Goldilocks, the Fairy Queen. After escaping, Red Riding Hood finally makes it to Grandmother's house, only to find the Big Bad Wolf has beaten her there. Fortunately, with the help of the three little pigs, the wolf has defeated once again. So I gave this an 8 out of 10 skulls. It was one of my more favorite Disney shorts, and let me tell you why. So it starts off with the same song from the Three Little Pigs, the Who's Afraid of the Big Bad Wolf, the Big Bad Wolf, the Big Bad Wolf. And, you know, that's always a nice thing. It's like a continuation. So it's cool because in the beginning when they were doing like the credits, like how they usually like list the actors and whatever, they actually listed the characters as the actors. So instead of saying like, oh, Pfeiffer Pig is played by this person and, you know, this pig is played by this person, they actually just listed the characters as if they were the actors, which was really nice. Red Riding Hood looked like a China doll. She looked so delicate and so fragile that she looked like a literal China doll. And it looked like if I were to like just hold her or like gently place her down, I'd accidentally break her and I'd feel so bad. And Red Riding Hood also mysteriously sounds like Snow White, which the actress for Snow White only really did Snow White and the Seven Dwarves, along with a brief cameo in The Wizard of Oz. So I wonder why she sounds like her. The Practical Pig sounds like Jiminy Cricket, I think. He just sounded very familiar to me. I think it was Jiminy Cricket. If you guys end up watching The Big Bad Wolf and I am like gravely mistaken, please correct me in the comment section down below of who the actor actually is. So there was wine in the short and I wrote, oh no, wine? Not in my Disney short. Heaven forbid they have alcohol. One of the notes I wrote was, did you not learn from the first encounter? Pretty much the three little pigs got outsmarted, or two of the pigs got outsmarted by the wolf again. And I'm thinking, this just happened maybe like a couple minutes or even before you defeated the wolf the first time. So why have you fallen for it again? I guess if they didn't, there wouldn't be a plot though, right? The wolf looks like, okay, when the wolf was like dressed as Goldilocks, the fairy, he looked like Goofy dressed in drag. It was absolutely hilarious. I'd have to know, how did the wolf know where Red was going? I mean, did he like eavesdrop in on her conversation with the pigs? Because that's really the only way he would know. If memory serves, she never told him where she was going, so. Oh, Aurora's spindle is in the background in Granny's house, and it looked exactly like the spindle from Sleeping Beauty, so I was pretty happy to see that. So there's a picture of Grandpa hanging on the wall in Granny's house, and you remember the Santa that I talked about in Santa's Workshop, the second ever Disney Media Review that I did? He looks exactly like that Santa from the short. It was pretty trippy. There was a fourth wall break. I will admit, at time of recording, it is December 13th, and I had written all these notes like 2 weeks ago, so I vaguely remember what this was. I'm pretty sure the wolf spoke to the audience, if memory serves me correctly. Okay, so you remember how I talked about in The Three Little Pigs when I found the dad as the sausage links? Well, there's another picture of supposed Uncle Otto, and he's a football! Can you believe it? And then there's some pretty heavy violence in this one too, which again, violence? Not in my Disney short. Anyway, I thank y'all so much for watching. If you end up watching this short for yourself, let me know what you think of it in the comment section down below. And other than that, I will see you tomorrow. Bye, little skeletons. Stay safe, and I love you guys.